My name's Craig Fitzpatrick. I lead our customer-facing delivery team here at SandboxAQ. I get to wake up every day and focus on three types of problems that customers might have who are on their own journey toward adopting applied quantum technologies or AI technologies. I work with our quantum security group, our sensing team, and our simulation and optimization team to deliver all three of those technologies into both the commercial and federal markets. That means that I get to spend my time learning a lot on the job about AI and quantum in the context of how our customers see our technology. I get to work on a lot of unique problems because of that role that I have in a customer-facing capacity. The most interesting one that I'm working on right now is I'm helping our quantum sensing team work on adopting our in-flight sensor to an Air Force specific and then more broadly government specific use case. And that means that I get to help an Air Force pilot, and I used to be in the Air Force, so as a veteran that's meaningful to me, find their way home, see the ground, see the Earth's magnetic field, and then use the information that we can get from nature, from the quantum signals that are all around us to help a pilot navigate if their GPS gets jammed. That's a really meaningful use case for me as someone who grew up loving aviation and aircraft, went to the Air Force Academy, actually served in the Air Force, worked on airplanes, and now is getting to apply that knowledge and that background in my day-to-day career. How did I get attracted to AI and quantum? I've worked in other forms of machine learning for a while, but I had never really learned much about applied quantum technology until I heard about SandboxAQ. And I didn't know what the A and the Q actually meant the first time I heard about the company. And the advice that I got from Jen Sovada, our president of public sector, and what I would repeat to anybody that's interested in working in our field but might not have a background in either AI or quantum, is don't let those words intimidate you. You can learn it too. I did. As somebody that's more than 20 years into my career, SandboxAQ supported my really foundational education in learning what a quantum computer is, how applied quantum leverages other types of quantum technology that isn't a quantum computer, what a quantum algorithm is. I got access to MIT's X-Pro coursework to learn some of those foundational concepts, and then I get amazing on-the-job training every day as a non-career scientist from scientists that I work with that are willing to take their time, teach me concepts in the way that I need to understand them to explain to our customers, as well as make technologies that our customers might want fit their specific use case. There's three main ways that I stay up to date on AI and quantum. The first one, and the most important one, is we've got an incredibly collaborative organization with a flat structure where we all feel free to ask each other questions about what we are seeing, either from a customer-specific use case or a hard technological problem that our engineering team is trying to solve. One example of that is that as quantum computers become an increasing threat to cybersecurity networks, I get to learn from our engineering team how the vulnerabilities that are in some of the algorithms that are deployed to defend networks and file systems and applications are becoming vulnerable by the work that NIST is doing to try and figure out how systems may be vulnerable 5 years from now, 10 years from now, as well as how they're vulnerable today. The second way that I stay up to date is there's a lot of news right now about cybersecurity generally and the potential threat of quantum computers to networks and systems specifically. And the news sources that we get kind of given to us and called down and curated from a platform called Leadership Connect actually give us content that we can find in a digest version of, for example, how the government may be changing a policy to require deeper implementation of quantum-resistant cryptography. And then the third way that I stay up to date is we've got an incredible culture of education and learning, and we get offered both external courses as well as internal courses all the time that are available to us on our own schedule where we can do that additional education and stay current on knowledge that we might not otherwise realize we needed to do our jobs every day.